Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use visual text network analysis and GPT-3 AI to analyze and interpret your dreams. So in the end, you get something like this, where you can have a map of the images and the concepts you're dreaming about, that you can see how they're connected to one another, what are the recurrent patterns that tend to come up in your dreams, where you can also zoom in and see what you've been dreaming about, a certain concept, and more importantly, where you can also discover the gaps in between the images and patterns that you see in your dreams, because those gaps indicate some very interesting connections that you could make in your everyday lives or in dreams as well. And this approach, of course, can be very useful for understanding yourself or self-analysis. Also, it's just a very interesting thing to do, some sort of introspection. And it can have beneficial effects on your psychological state. And also, if you're interested in lucid dreaming, it's one of the approaches that you can use to actually start to become aware of your dreams while you're dreaming. Because once you detect the patterns that tend to occur and you recognize them, then next time you're dreaming, you can detect that the dream is happening, so you can start to modify it from inside the dream. So all this can be done using this approach. And I just want to say we have a longer video with a tutorial of everything step by step, where I explain step by step in detail how this approach works. In this video, I just want to show very quickly the main idea so you understand how to do that. So first of all, you would need to import all your dreams into InfraNodus, and you have several ways of doing that. You can just write down your dreams when you dream, or you can import it from any journaling app or maybe just your notepad, and then in the end you will have something like this, which is a graph of the concepts and images that you're dreaming about. And the more influential ones are shown bigger on the graph, like for example house and people. In this case, these are my dreams, and if the terms tend to occur together more often, they will be connected and they will also have the same color if they belong to the same cluster. So you can quickly see what you're dreaming about in general and in which context, right? So for example, here we have the orange cluster on roads and driving. So it means that I'm dreaming about road and driving in the same context. Okay, so this allows me to kind of get a quick overview of the dreams. And also here is a very interesting feature, which I just turned on, which interprets those clusters that were identified in your dreams using GPT-3 AI. So this is an interpretation made by AI of what I'm dreaming about. And as you can see, there are quite deep stuff here. Dreamscape, creative thinking, dreaming about work, home, lost identity or losing something, journey mapping, and road adventure. So it's about thinking, perception, home, dreams, road adventures, okay? And this is a very useful way to kind of get like an overview of your dreams. Then you can, of course, like I said, zoom into the specific dreams and see what you've been dreaming about these particular topics. You can click on every node. And for example, to see what you've been dreaming about, road, continuing and reaching something. And then you can see in which dream it was happening, right? And what was the exact thing that happened when you were dreaming about these concepts. Then you can deselect them and zoom into some other topic and explore it as well. So this is like a very good way to analyze and explore your dreams. And I encourage you to use the graph to do it in a visual way, but you can also use GPT-3 interpretation of the graph or of each topic. So for example, you can even select this one. And then if you click AI Insight and develop, then it will try to develop the idea based on the concepts or images that it finds in this cluster. So it's not sending your dream to GPT-3, it's rather sending the concepts. And then you can have an interpretation of what this cluster means. So then you start understanding yourself better and you start understanding your dreams also much better. Then if you deselect this, you can also select specific concepts. Like for example, here I'm talking about feeling and maybe energy and talking. And what happens here is that I can ask GPT-3 to generate some content that relates to these terms, but also taking the whole graph into account. So it's going to take the structure of my dreams into account, but try to generate content that relates to feeling the energy and talking. And then I'm going to click develop, and it's going to create a sort of summary of those terms, but in relation to the whole picture of the dream, right? So, and usually if we're analyzing dreams, it's going to sound a little bit like a dream in itself. So it's kind of like a summary or a zoom into this particular aspect of your dreaming, right? And so the felt energy, talk of the room, dream nature, thought, paper found in the office, water case and car stage connected us to our father's woman's body waiting for us to tell an interesting story about our people, walking along the road, lake, hill, stop driving and talking until we reached the house, and that brought back memories from the time when we had big dreams and plans to make it come true. So sometimes it may sound a little bit gibberish, but it's also a good thing because we're actually analyzing a dream, and this is where GPT-3 kind of shines in this context, because it's made to generate content, but now we're asking it to generate content from our dreams. And ironically, this is also what's happening in the dreams. You know, our brain is connecting different ideas together and generates content for us. So it's kind of like a nice interaction between the subconscious and the GPT-3 AI. I don't know if anyone else is actually feeding the subconscious into GPT, but it's pretty interesting when you try it, especially if you use your own data. And here is again another one. The people in the room felt energized as they talked about their big dreams and brought nature inside, making them feel happy. You see, so if you don't like the first option, then you can regenerate more and so on, and then it generates you some really interesting content that could even potentially be an inspiration for another dream or maybe for some real life experience. Then another thing which is really nice to do is to find the gaps in the dreams, so highlighting the gaps or the topics that could be better connected, and then trying to think of a connection between them, right? So what happens here is that it identifies clusters that could be better connected, and then it tries to propose you to think of a connection between them. So for example, here we see, let's regenerate more. These ones could be interesting. Work realities and creative thinking. So it means in one context, I was dreaming about work realities here, this green one on the right, and another one about creative thinking here on the left. But they were not so connected. So Infernotis proposes me to think of a connection between them. And this is usually has a really high potential because it means that those images come up in the unconscious, but not so often together. And so I can either do this interpretation manually, just by kind of clicking here and exploring a little bit what those concepts might mean. Time, think, realize, start, make, thought. Okay, I can also go here and try to see what those concepts are about and try to make the interpretation of the connection myself. Or another way is to also do this manually. So I'm just gonna reset the highlight and then select it again and show you how it's done. Gonna take a bit of a moment. So I highlight the gap again and then choose the same gap as we had before by clicking this button here. Okay, creative flow, work realities. Okay, and then I can use the AI to generate an interesting research question that would connect those together. So I can either connect it myself and think that, okay, maybe there is more creativity that I was lacking somehow when I was dreaming about work. So some kind of dreaming about routine work and then dreaming about creativity, but not about them at the same time. So it could be an interesting question to ask myself if I could dream about this sort of connection more. But I could also click here and then the AI will try to make the link for you and generate some content that would connect them together. What kind of long-term effects can leaving an important office have on a girl's emotional well-being, and how can this be effectively managed to ensure a good start in her new life? So it kind of might look weird, but it's because we've been analyzing dreams and dreams are weird. But the advantage here is that you're not using it to generate a ready-made thing. It's kind of to inspire you how you could make a connection here. And the interesting thing here is about dreaming leaving a workspace or even quitting work and how it affects life. So maybe this is also an interesting thing for me to think about. You know, maybe what would happen if I stopped working and gave myself to creative work, for instance, how would it affect me? Maybe it's a thought that I can have and then it can come in my dreams. I can also generate something else and it's going to be maybe completely different or not, and you know, use another gap. So for example, here I'm going to choose another gap, let's say here, something that looks more far apart from each other. Like, this can be interesting, lost identity, home arrangements. Weird, but let's see what comes up. And then it's going to generate some question that would motivate me or encourage me to think in this direction. And sometimes it might seem a little bit strange, the sentences it makes, but actually if you try reading it and try to understand it, it will most of the time be quite interesting. You know, for instance here, what are the implications of an unmarried woman waiting for her father in a city when her body is lost in an interesting house inside of which water can be found, and she might ask for the case to an end the stage? So it's like almost like an indie movie scenario that we have here. But if you try to think what that image might mean for you, you will surprisingly find a lot of really interesting interpretations. So this is like a very powerful tool to use. And actually, what's interesting here is that we're using data science tools to analyze our personality. And it's quite interesting to do and exciting. And I encourage you to try it out. So there's a lot more features that you can try. I encourage you to watch the longer video with the full explanation of how all of this works and more specifics. I will leave the comment and the description, the link to this video in the description below. So please watch it if you're interested, or just try it out if you already know how Infernodus works on your own dreams and data. You can even just put in your thoughts or something that you've been writing down about a particular topic and use the same approach. It will be very interesting. So I encourage you to try it. Thank you very much. And let me know if you have any questions or comments and feedback in the comments of this video or through our support portal. Thank you.